Here we have the integral of tangent of x secant squared of x dx. So for this problem, we could try to use the u substitution. U equals tangent of x. So then du equals secant squared of x dx. And du divided by secant squared of x equals dx. That will give us the integral of u times secant squared of x times du over secant squared of x. Our secant squared of x's cancel out, and we're left with the integral of u du, which is u squared divided by 2 plus c, and when we plug back in for u, we get tangent of x quantity squared divided by 2 plus a constant. Now, there's also another way that we could have gone about solving this. So what if instead we tried the substitution u equals secant of x? So if u equals secant of x, then du equals secant of x tangent of x dx. So du divided by secant of x tangent of x equals dx. So then we have the integral of tangent of x, and we have, let's just leave this as secant squared of x for now. We're going to wait to plug in that u, and that's times dx is du divided by tangent of x secant of x. So you see now why we waited to substitute in our u. Because this tangent of x and this tangent of x here cancel, and the secant of x cancels with one of these secants of x's. So we have the integral of secant of x du. Now we're ready to plug in for u. So we have the integral of u du. So when we take the integral of u du, we get u squared divided by 2 plus a constant, and we're going to call this constant d. So plugging back in for u, we get secant squared of x divided by 2 plus d. So the question is, does this equal tangent squared of x divided by 2 plus our constant c? And it should, because we did the integral two different ways, and we got kind of what looks like two different answers, but we'll see that these, in fact, are the same thing. We have the Pythagorean identity, 1 plus tangent squared of x equals secant squared of x. So using this and plugging in for secant squared of x, we get 1 plus tangent squared of x divided by 2 plus d. So then we have, separating this into two fractions, we have 1 plus half plus tangent squared of x divided by 2 plus d. So what this says is that tangent squared of x divided by 2 plus 1 half plus d is equal to tangent squared of x divided by 2 plus c. So this 1 half plus d equals my constant c. So we did get the same answer. Here we have the integral of tangent cubed of theta times secant of theta d theta. So let's try our u substitution. What happens if we let u equal secant of theta? Then du equals secant of theta tangent of theta d theta. So du divided by secant of theta tangent of theta equals d theta. So we get the integral of tangent cubed of theta times secant of theta times du over secant theta tangent of theta. So we can cancel out our secants, cancel out one of our tangents, so we're left with the integral of tangent squared theta du. So we have theta, we have u, we have tangent, but our u is secant. So we might wonder if we even chose the right u. But if we had chosen u to be tangent, then our derivative would have been secant squared, and we only have one secant to cancel out. So instead, let's think about our identities. We've talked before about the Pythagorean identity, that tangent squared plus 1 equals secant squared. Oops, tangent squared of theta plus 1 equals secant squared of theta. So this might be useful. We can relate tangent and secant, which is good, because we want to end up with something in terms of u, which is secant of theta. So if we say, okay, tangent squared of theta equals secant squared of theta minus 1. So our integral becomes the integral of secant squared of theta minus 1 du. And secant squared of theta, so secant of theta is u, so that means that secant squared is u squared minus 1 du. We can take this integral, that is u cubed divided by 3 minus u plus a constant c, and plugging back in for u, we get secant cubed of theta divided by 3 minus secant of theta plus c.